you get a different perspective when you get in a vessel and you go a mile offshore and you look at Milwaukee, which seems like a big city, and it shrinks very small, and you realize how big this system is.
It's 20% of the world's fresh surface water, 95% of the fresh surface water in the United States.
And they're surprisingly fragile, and we have had, you know, major impact on them.
The saying that the next wars will be fought over water versus oil, I think, is very true. We're seeing the impact today, even in our own country, even in nearby states, of the impact of not having clean, fresh water.
30 million people in the United States alone rely on the Great Lakes for their drinking water. We need to have some world-class support. If we don't have healthy Great Lakes, we are simply not going to have a healthy economy.
To think about the School of Freshwater Science and just to really understand how valuable it is to this community, the research and the expertise and the scientific knowledge that they bring has had a really long-standing and lasting impact on this community.
Milwaukee is becoming a leader globally in the advancement of water technology, water industry, and water research. And this research vessel is a state-of-the-art instrument, is part of that entire effort. The beloved Niske, and I love the Niske, is old now, and nothing lasts forever.
And if you look at the equipment that's evolved over that time to do DNA sequencing and the amount of knowledge we've gained, the lives that have been saved, just think about if we were still trying to solve those issues with equipment that was 60 years old. We would not be anywhere along the lines of the great discoveries we've had related to the human body. And I think it's the same way with water in the Great Lakes. We need to have an updated research vessel so that we can accelerate the research that's going on and the learning.
It's essentially a floating research laboratory. It's a much bigger vessel and will accommodate many more scientists. We can take classes out on the boat. We can take interdisciplinary teams of scientists. They can bring their research instrumentation and have it right on board rather than back in the laboratory. Right now we're limited to just running out in the lake and coming back to the lab. We can now put the lab on the boat. We don't need to run back here. The vessel will have a much further range, so we can operate further afield. We can go out to sea for, you know, 10 days, 2 weeks. The boat will be dynamically positioned, which means that the thruster systems on board will have it hover in place when we're doing specific experiments on the bottom. I mean, this research vessel, I think, will be a hallmark of the institution, and not by that I mean UWM.
This is probably one of the most important investments you can make at this point in time in Milwaukee. This is an investment that will pay off for years to come in both bringing new talent into Milwaukee through graduate students and more researchers. But more importantly, you're going to be saving people's lives.
That's what's going to make this place, as people like to say, the Silicon Valley of water.
How often can you make a direct investment that you can point to in the future and say, this is something that's really changed lives of people in Africa, Flint, Michigan, all over this globe?
Just think about how much better our beaches, our lakes, our water can be. So it's a great opportunity, a really great organization, and we certainly would ask others to consider investing and helping support.
Water is our health, it's our economy, and it's our quality of life. And the Great Lakes are immensely important, and understanding them, being good stewards of this resource in the future, that's our responsibility, and that's what this research vessel will do. That's what this institution is designed to do.